Hello, this is a short tutorial about the SPML Comp and the type of file it accepts as input. SPML Comp is a web application to analyze, compare, and create constraint-based metabolic models. If you do not have any metabolic models but still would like to test and use the tool, you can download some on big models. On the web application, you should click on Select Model to select a file from your computer. If the file has an invalid extension, when you click on the upload button, you will receive an error message listing the file extensions accepted by the web application. If you select a file with a valid extension, but it is not a valid model, when you click on the upload button, you will receive an error message indicating that it was not possible to read the file. If the model was saved in the SBML format, you can use the SBML validator to look for errors in your file. If your models have a valid file extensions and are valid models, you can select between 1 and 10 models to be analyzed and compared by the tool. Then, when you click on the upload button, the models will be sent to the server located at the Leipzig University. This process usually takes from a few seconds to a minute, depending on how many models were selected and how fast your internet connection is. In the second session, you have the option to infer the name of the modeled organism according to the KEG and BioPsych database. KEG has about 7,000 annotated organisms, and BioPsych has about 14,000. At this link, you can find a list of all organisms annotated by KEG, organized according to their taxonomy. Enter the organism name might be relevant because the web application will be able to map the model's reactions to pathways expected to exist in the organism and identify reactions possibly missing in the model. To find the name of an organism in the database, you need to type at least 3 letters, and a list with up to 100 organism names will be shown to you. It's not necessary to start writing its name from its first word. If you choose not to enter the organism name, the web application will map the reactions in the model to all the pathways in the database and find the minimum set of pathways that contain the model's reaction. In case you have actual biolog phenotype data at hand and want to compare the simulation results to experimental results, it might make sense to provide oxygen to the growth medium, as biolog experiments are usually performed in aerobic medium. If your model represents an aerobic organism, it may also be interesting to check whether your model can or cannot grow in a medium without oxygen. Once this step is finished, you can click on the button Start New Analysis. In the next session, you will find two progress bars. The first one, the model analysis, shows the progress of analyses that are independent of other models, like the growth simulations and the reactions mapping. The second bar, the model comparison, shows the progress of the pairwise comparison when the web application finds unique and shared reactions between models and calculates how similar the models are. Because every model is compared with every other model, the number of comparisons grows very quickly when more models are included in the analysis. This is one of the reasons why it was set an upper limit of 10 models to be compared. The analysis of a single small model usually takes 1 or 2 minutes. However, the server can run jobs for up to 2 hours, which should be enough to analyze and compare up to 10 models. If you don't want to keep your web browser open to wait for the analysis result, you can enter your email address and you will be notified when the analysis is complete. Well, that's all. See you in the next tutorial.